गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 1, टाइप्स ऑफ नेटवर्क टोपोलॉजीज। द मेन एम, द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट इज द स्टडी ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ नेटवर्क टेक्नोलॉजी। नाउ फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज नेटवर्क टोपोलॉजी? So there are the various categories of network topologies. It is the systematic description of a network, arrangement, the connection, the various nodes from one end to the sender and another end receiver through the lines of the connections. So how can we connect the sender and the receiver, the various technologies to create a network, various topologies we have used. Number one is bus topology. Bus topology is a network type in which every computer and the network devices is connected to a single cable, only a single cable. It has exactly two endpoints, then it is called linear bus topologies. Here having some features of bus topologies. Number one, it transmits data only in one direction, and every device is connected to a single cable. Some advantages of bus topologies: it cost effective because it is linear. That's why they are providing the cost effective in terms of minimum cost you pay. Second one, the cable required is least compared to the other network topologies. They are using less as compared to the other topologies. They are using less cables required for this. Use in a small networks, and it is easy to understand how to be used. Easy to explain the joining two cables together. Some of the disadvantages of bus topologies: cable falls, then hold the network is fails. Agar ek cable kharab hoti hai, to hold the network is fail. If traffic is heavy or nodes are more, performance in the network are decreases. Traffic congestions occur. Traffic, we can say traffic will be increases the nodes and the more performance of the network decreases. Cable has a limited length, and the other one is it is compared with the ring topologies, it is slower than the ring topologies. Now move on to the ring topologies. It is called ring topologies because it forms a ring, as each computer is connected to another computer with the least one connected to the first, exactly two neighbors for each device. Just like we are just showing a diagram, we are just making a form of ring. Some of the features for the ring topologies in terms of number of repeaters are used for the ring topologies with large number of nodes, because if someone wants to send the data to the last node in the ring, then we can say we are taking 100 nodes, so the data will be have to pass it through all the 99 nodes to reach the 100th node. Hence, to prevent the data, the loss repeaters are used in networks. The transmission is basically undirectional, and it can be a bi-directional by having two connection between the each network node. It is called dual ring topologies. If the direction in terms of we are discussing about is, if both the direction we are using for sending the data and receiving the data, they are using two wires. In dual topologies, they are providing the two rings are formed and the data is opposite directions. If we are sending on the other side, we are sending data or receiver data. And then also, if one ring fails, the second ring can act as a backup. Agar ek ring fail ho jati, the other ring will be act as a first one and make the network to work. The data transfer sequentially manner, that is a bit-to-bit transformation, has to be a process through a region. And having some advantages, transferring the data is not affected by heavy traffic or by adding more nodes, as only a node having tokens can be transmitted data from one to another. Cheap to install. Basically, we are having in terms of cost, it's cheap to install them. And some of the disadvantages: troubling of difficult running topologies in terms of troubleshooting, adding or deleting the computer distribution back to and the network activities, and failure. If one of the system is failed in distributor, the whole network will be suffering from this. Move on to star topology. Again, diagram shows All the computers are connected to one central device is called hub or a switch. Each device requires a cable connect point to point connection between the devices and the hubs. Implementation in terms of a failure when they are having any single point of failure is a failure of failing the particular data is transmitted. Some of the advantages of STAR topologies: effective troubleshooting is quite efficient in STAR topologies as compared to the bus topologies. In the bus topologies, the manager has to inspect the kilometers of the cable and STAR topologies. All the connections are connected to the centralized network. Network control, complex network control features can be easily be implemented in STAR topologies, and any changes made in STAR topologies are automatically accommodated. Sometimes there are many limited failures in terms of each connection is connected to the central hub with its own cable. Therefore, a failure in one cable will be affected to the entire network. Family technologies. In terms of established family, as the tools are cost effective, easy expandable, cost effective, and high speed data should be achieving by STAR topologies. Some of the disadvantages advantage of STAR topologies in terms of the central point of the failure. If the central hub of the switch goes down, then all the connected nodes will not be able to communicate with each other. In terms of cable, sometimes cable routing becomes difficult when a significant amount of data is required to be connected for each node. Tree topologies combine the characteristics of bus topologies and STAR topologies, and just showing them that they are having basically two combinations of them, and then they provide a structure for the computers are connected with each other in their applications. A topmost node in the three technologies known as a root node, and all other nodes are decentralized of the root node. There is only one path exists between the two nodes of the data transfer if I form a parent and child hierarchy in the three topologies. Advantages in terms of they are providing support for the broadband transmission, mainly used to provide a broadband transmission, so that signals are sent over a long distance without being affected, and easily expandable, easy manageable. Error detection, then we have a point the error detection and error correction is very easy in STAR topologies. And limited failure, the breakdown in one station does not affect the entire network, because in the STAR topologies, if hub is having any failure or the network is down, then all the nodes are not sending the data between them. Disadvantages of tree topologies in terms of difficult troubleshooting. If any fault is occur in the node, then becomes difficult to troubleshoot the problems, because they are having a start which particular node having suffered from this. High cost devices are required to run transmission are very costly, and failure at topologies mainly relies on the main bus cables, and the failure in a main bus will damage the overall network. Reconfiguration, again it is a difficult task. If the devices are added, then it becomes difficult to reconfigure. Mass topologies is an arrangement of the network in which computers are interconnected, which either through the various ADM connections. There are multiple paths from one computer to another computer, and it contains the switches in the hub or any central computer which acts as the central point of the communications. Internet is the basic example of the mass topologies. And mass topologies is mainly used for the WAN implementation where communication failures and critical concerns are. They mainly use the wireless network, and the mass topologies can be formed by the formulas to be calculating the n number of nodes representing in terms of n dot n minus 1 is divided by 2 for the network. The mass topologies is divided into two categories, full and partial. In terms of fulls, we can say each computer is connected to all the computers available in the network, and partial in terms of the mass topology, not all the certain computers are connected to those computers which can be communicated frequently. And some of the disadvantages, advantages in the reliable connections, fast communication, and easy reconfigure. The mass topology network are very reliable in terms of link breakdown will not be affected the communication between the connected computers. And adding new would be disturb the communication between the devices. A disadvantage in terms of cost, contain a large number of connected devices such as the routers, more transmission medium than the other topologies. Management, when we are discussing about the management, the mesh of the network are very large and difficult to maintain and manage. and the network is monitored carefully, then the communication link frequency goes down to undetected. In this topology, the latency connections are high, but the reduces the effective as post. And now we are discussing the hybrid technology. The combination of various different topologies is known as hybrid. Hybrid is connection between different links and the nodes to transfer the data. When two or more different topologies are combined together in terms of a hybrid, if similar topologies are connected to each other, will be presenting the result in a hybrid topologies. For example, there exists a ring topology in one branch of ICE. In another example, bus example, using the ICE, then connecting these topologies will create a hybrid. Some of the advantages in terms of reliable transmission. If fault is occurring in any part of the network, it will not affect the function of the rest of the network. Scalability baat karne, the size of the network can easily expand to adding the new devices without affecting the functionality of the existing networks. Flexible, in terms of topology, is very flexible as it can be designed according to the requirement of the organization. Effective, hybrid technology is very effective as it can be designed to such that a way the strength of the network is maximized and the weakness of the network is minimized. A disadvantage, in terms of again the using as a complex design. Because the major drawback of the hybrid topology is designed to a hybrid network, it is very difficult to design the architecture of hybrid networks. Costly hubs are used in the hybrid topology are very expensive, as these hubs are different from the user hubs used in the topologies. And costly infrastructure are providing very hybrid networks will require lots of cable and network devices are using in them. Thank you. So these are basically the topologies mainly used in a network, and how can we create the data, how can we insertion or the connected to the one node to the other node and how to transfer the data. This is a basic structure to form of them on the network topology.